Thank you, Simon. Musician and actress Kelly Khumalo has been in the news again recently after she cut short a performance at an EFF rally last week. Khumalo performed just two songs before walking off the stage, ending her performance at the rally in Durban after people started chanting hashtag justice for Senzo. She says, "I was in a relationship with Senzo and I am in the public eye, and I think that people think that I'm an easy target." Kelly Khumalo joins us now in studio. It's making me feel like I'm really underdressed for this interview, Kelly. But welcome. Thank you so much for joining
us. Thank you for having me.
So let's talk about this rally. What exactly happened? And what made you
first of
storm
all
off,
when my team and I got there, we were already running late. So we were told that Julius is about to talk, so we don't have much time on stage. So we decided we were going to cut my performance short. So when I went on stage, obviously the energy, I'm not gonna lie to you, the energy was very tense. And for me, I operate on energy. I'm a creative. I operate on a very light and positive energy, and that energy
tense? I mean, you're going to a political rally.
They were
rally.
Very agitated by the fact that their leader was running late as well. So the crowd was already agitated. It had absolutely nothing to do with me. So when I got off stage, I didn't even see those plaques that those placards that they were talking about.
But what made you cut your performance short?
For me, they were very tense.
So that's what made you?
Extremely. For me, I operate on positive energy. But if you've seen some of the clips of the EFF, they're all about war. Everything that they represent is all about
fighting. In such an event? And I mean, obviously, we know during campaigning this period, we see a lot of celebrities who support or endorse.
It's not even about, for me, I'll speak for myself, not for everybody. For me, work is work. So
for you, you're just going.
I'm just going there to work, not to support anything. I was just booked for the event, and I went there as a musician, not as a member of any political party.
So there was no political affiliation.
No, not at all.
Okay. So now let's talk about when you realized those hashtag justice for Senzo.
I actually saw them the next morning when I was asleep, and a friend of mine sends me an SMS to say, "Are you okay?" I'm like, "What are you talking about?" So when I went to check on Twitter, I'm trending. I'm like, okay, what's new? I'm so used to it, so it doesn't really mean much to me.
But you did an interview saying that you decided to clap back because you're tired of being trolled,
being
bullied.
Absolutely, because I'm at the point where if you have something to say, if you have evidence on Senzo's passing, why don't you approach the police station or the investigating officers that are in charge of the case instead of dragging me down just because I'm in the public eye, and it makes it easier for you to just say whatever you
but
feel
is
right.
But this is not the first time that people are saying you should come up with answers. Chico Twyla at some point said,
let me tell you, people will say whatever they want to say, and they will believe whatever they want to believe. At the end of the day, we have left everything in the hands of justice and counting on our police to do their job.
So let's talk about justice. Minister Peggy Kelly had said very recently that they're very close to making arrests, but then at an advanced stage. Your sister, however, was saying that you, as a family, are constantly going to the police station.
Absolutely. It's been an ongoing back and forth between my family and the people that were in the house. So it's been an ongoing back and forth. They need that information. We go through and give that information. We've never held anything away from the police. We've given everything that we know, everything that we've seen on that particular day. So, Nati, we are not investigators. We are victims of the crime that took place on that night. So all I'm saying is that let the justice take place. Don't be the one to want to now take justice into your hands.
And I must ask you, I mean, the way your sister portrayed it, how it's affected you as a family and affected you as an individual.
My mother has a heart problem based on this. You know, it was a very traumatic experience for me and my family that we are trying to move from, and the public is not making it easy for us. And all I'm pleading for is for the police to do their jobs.
What's the progress on that? What are you hearing?
I spoke to the head of investigators, which was, I think, last week. and are asked about the progress, and obviously they keep changing investigating officers. Mm. I mean, if you were to ask how many officers they've changed since the death of Senzo, it's been like so many of them.
I've lost count.
We meet people, new people all the time. The old stuff is gone. You have a new investigating officer that you have to deal with. Of course, there'll be cracks through in the investigation, mm. because a new person comes in, an old person is gone. We've gone so far with the investigation, and then a new person comes in.
But I'm keen to understand how this has affected also your relationship with Senzo's family.
I've never had a relationship with those people, so we don't have a relationship.
I don't even want to talk about that. But just going forward, obviously this has also had an impact on you, as you say, as a creative. You deal with energy.
Yeah.
So that is some negative energy. That is some toxic energy.
Also, I don't dwell on negative energy. I will not let people who assume know what happened that night pull me down. That is something that I'm not going to let happen.
But it has also spurred you on in a positive way, creatively. You've written even a song.
I've written beautiful music based on that. I mean, I have the latest song, Jehovah. It says, "Batisebe wenzile bonke bethi bangiqiba." They've tried to bury me, but they will never succeed because I stand with my truth and I know what my truth is.
Which is
I was a victim on that night, and I'm not here to defend myself. The law will do that.
Obviously, it's hard for you to speculate on why people are asking for answers from you. Where do you think the negativity comes from?
Based on people, ma'am. Mm. If you want to know what they want to, what they're speculating on, you are more than free to ask them. But I will not speak on their behalf. I'm here to speak on my behalf. Mm.
I understand. I'm just saying, is it something that you think about that occupies your mind?
I can never dwell on something that has nothing to do with me. It's their perception of what happened. Mm. And it has nothing to do
with
me.
So let's take you where it has, look at where it's taken you creatively. The acting, the singing. Tell us about the past couple of years in light of that. And as you say, there's been positive and negative.
I more than anything, I focus on the positive. Mm. I mean, immediately after that, I won the Best Afropop at the Metros. Immediately after that, I performed for the president of Angola, where he was being inaugurated. Immediately after that, I have an amazing album, Unleashed. I've released two videos. I'm on the third single in the album, which is Ngiyazithandela. I'm dropping another single this Friday. So for me, they are propelling me to be the best that I can possibly be. And I believe that God will never give me this task if I don't have the power to handle it. So for me, I always focus on the positive.
Mm. Kelly, I mean, I know the last time you and I spoke and we did an interview, we were talking about you coming out of a different phase of your life and being committed to it. How has that journey been? Have you been able to keep the terrible past in the past firmly so?
I don't dwell in the past. Mm. If it's not constructive, it is not for me. I have always been a woman of God who believes in nothing but positivity. So everything is behind. I've blocked my ears. I will say whatever I want to say when I want to say it, if it benefits me, if it motivates me. If it doesn't, it's left behind.
All right, let's talk about what you want to say about this new song.
Which song?
So the single Jehovah, which you've spoken about,
there's
Ngiyazithandela.
Ngiyazithandela. It just came out recently, and it's just the airplay is picking up, which is great. So I'm thankful for that. The song is about a person that I love very much, and I'm affirming that I am in love with that person.
Is it a spiritual being? Is it a human being that we can see?
But we are all spiritual beings, aren't we?
Okay, so is it somebody that you want to talk about?
It's one person that I am very much content with the fact that I love this person. And
is it a romantic relationship? Let me ask that.
It is very much romantic and it's beautiful.
And any major announcements that are forthcoming anytime soon?
Maybe. Definitely maybe.
Okay, so
definitely maybe.
Are you going to tell us whom?
No.
No. You're keeping that close to your chest.
At this moment, no. I am not at liberty to disclose
it. But it's clearly somebody who's making you happy because you are blushing as you speaking.
I am happy. I am not going to hide the fact that I'm happy. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to hide the fact that I'm taken good care of. So,
is he in the music video?
No.
Possibly,
no.
Yes, maybe.
No. What are you looking for exactly?
Just a tidbit.
No. And if people want to know, they can just follow me on Instagram. I have something to say to them tomorrow morning.
Well, you heard it here first. So Kelly Khumalo is going to drop something. And we are playing out with one of her songs titled Dance Comigo.
You dance for me, Your beauty defines my aura. You're good to me like a dollar.
Here I am, use me, oh.
Your beauty defines my aura. You're good to me like a dollar.
Here I am, use me, oh.
Would you dance with me again? Dance comigo. Would you dance with me forever? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Would you dance with me again? Dance comigo. Would you dance with me forever?